Okay, this is José Dapena from Igalia. Today I'm going to talk about the work I've been doing with the Windows native stack profiling and the updates on the feature in this year. Okay, so first a definition. Callstack profiling, it's a performance analysis tool. Basically, it samples periodically the call stacks of all threads for a workload. Why? We want to get a better understanding of the CPU-bound performance problems. It provides a breakdown of the code that is exhausting CPU resources. It's good for initial analysis of the problem, but it also allows deep dives later. And also, it allows to compare different implementations to understand the improvements and the regressions. So how does it work? First, on compilation stage, we need to generate the functional information and frame pointers. And then on runtime stage, the JIT compilation is going to also generate functional information. And the performance sampler will extract the call stack for all processes and threads periodically. Okay, so call stack profiling can benefit from system-wide sampling. So we want to include the system libraries and in the dependencies and in the analysis. We want to integrate that with all the metrics provided by the system. Many CPU-bound problems are not constrained to a simple single component, so it's important that we get system-wide data. Okay, so how do we do the recording? First, we need to compile with enable profiling equal to true, and this is a command line that could work for doing the captures. And for doing the actual recording, we can use Windows Performance Recorder or UI for ETW and record the session. About analysis, we can use the Windows Performance Analysis. We need to have the paths for the PDB symbol files. We need to use the sample CPU profile view of the tool. So about this year work, first thing is that now it's working again. That's a regression that was there, it was not working, and now it works. So that's great. Okay, so these are the changes. Basically, one of the things is that now we can do stock working independent of enabling interpreted frame stack, native frame stack integration. It's built by default, but there's no performance penalty when we are not profiling. Now it works also when Perfetto is enabled. The profiling performance have been improved significantly, and this is important. We generate far better method names, so it's easier to understand what we are tracing and what we are obtaining for the tool. So these are the main contributors for this year work. My work has been sponsored by Bloomberg, and it's available on V8 10.9. Thanks.
All right. Next up on stage, we'll have Yoav.